We believed before that Go is such a difficult game that computers can never learn how to play it. But Google's DeepMind developed a new algorithm for playing Go in 2016 called AlphaGo. And it played against many times world champion Lee Sedol from Korea, and AlphaGo won 4-1. And if you're curious to know more about this story, there's a very nice documentary that's available for free on YouTube or anywhere else, and it's called AlphaGo. And now, as of that moment, we find ourselves living in the new era of Go. The era of computer Go. A lot of the old variations, old joseki, old shapes were dethroned, and now we have new ideas, new variations, and new joseki in place. Of course, it's not possible to talk about all of those AI ideas in just one lesson, so we'll most assuredly get back to this wonderful topic in one of the future courses. But if I had to pick one major change that happened in the world of Go openings, then it would be this. It's the value of Sente at the beginning of the game. Sente being the move that maintains the initiative. When you make a move and your opponent has to reply, and it's your move again. And if you make a move and your opponent doesn't reply, then it's a Gote move. And these are the two major kinds of moves in Go. And computers say that we really can't overestimate the value of Sente. That's how tremendously important it is. But hey, let me show you how this works. Let's take this basic opening pattern, for example. We take the four star points, all the same. And now it would be quite reasonable for Black to approach one of the corners. And before AlphaGo, before computers, you were very likely to see something like this. White could defend the corner. And Black, of course, can jump inside right now, but Black can also choose to build a position here at the bottom. So Black threatens to steal the corner. White defends. Now White makes some territory here. And these stones are not alive yet. They don't have two eyes. So if White plays here, these stones will be under attack. So Black defends them right now, makes a two-space extension, and Black is safe. And this is one of the most basic josekis in Go. Everybody played this. Beginners, amateur players, professional players, we all learned this at the very beginning when we started to play Go. But those modern, super strong computers don't really agree with this. They think that every move in this joseki is wrong. Let's try to understand why that is. Let's see this one more time. When Black approaches this corner, Black has Sente right now. Now, White responds, Black plays here, White defends, and Black defends. And this is exactly where Black lost his Sente. Now, White doesn't have to respond to this move, so White will ignore this and play anywhere else. Maybe attack this corner or invade here. And keeping Sente in the opening is more important than almost anything else. But so let's see what should have happened here instead. When Black approaches here, White doesn't really have to respond. I mean, what's the worst thing that's going to happen? If Black approaches once again, this is a double attack. Well, after this, White can respond and attach to one of these stones. But before that, White is not forced to respond. So White can take Sente, Tanuki, and of course, Tanuki is very well connected with the concept of Sente. If you want to keep Sente, you ignore your opponent and you Tanuki, you play elsewhere. And White can approach this corner or invade. But let's say White responds. And again, Black shouldn't respond here right now. This is a nice exchange for Black. This move exchanged for this. And now Black should invade the corner, says AI. But let's imagine that Black still plays here. And you're getting the pattern, right? White really shouldn't respond here right now. White should, right, invade the corner and not make any exchanges here anymore. And even after this move, these stones are not safe yet. So it seems that Black should really defend them right now. But AI says no. You have to give them up. You have to ignore this and play somewhere else. And of course, White can attack them right now, but computers say, this is less important than the corner, so Black should just continue playing here, and whatever happens here, happens. But of course, we are not computers, and a computer will always find a very clever way of escaping with these stones, or maybe even sacrificing them in a beautiful way. But we can't do that, so my suggestion is this. Now that you have invested 2 stones in this area, maybe it's worth adding another stone just to make sure that everything goes smoothly and you are safe. So at this point, you should probably still consider adding another stone just for safety. But if you really want to ignore this and play Tanuki, then you should do this before you add any more stones, before you invest too much in this corner. And as for the actual AI suggestion here, computers think that it's better to attach like this. But this will lead to a lot of complicated variations, where black would get either a little bit more profit, or black will battle white for Sente. And we'll talk about this some other time. You might have noticed that I keep showing you that black should always invade here, and white should always invade here. And that is because computers really like these invasions. If there's one thing that computers value as much as Sente, that would be corners. And that goes very well with our corner side center principle. We always take corners first, and then we go on to the sides, and only then into the center. And computers do just that. You're very unlikely to see a computer play something like this at the very beginning of the game, make an extension on the side. Before this corner is enclosed, before this corner is invaded, that's not going to happen. So before any of this, black would of course want to enclose these corners and this corner and invade both of these. So let's take a look at this corner invasion, which has become incredibly popular these days. But first of all, try and figure out what happens after black invades here right now. So when black invades here, this is a joseki that was played here before. White has to block from this side or this side. Black crawls, trying to live here. And before, white would play like this. Black needs to live. So crawling one more time. And at this point, black felt that this group is not safe enough yet. So black felt that he had to add one more move to make it stronger and bigger. So black played one move here. White blocks. Black saves the stone. Now this corner is worth about 10 points, and there's a weakness left in white's position. So white needs to protect it. But instead of playing here, white typically plays like this, which is a nice shape. Tiger's mouth, remember? And I'm sure that my teacher wouldn't have praised me for invading this corner so early in the game, because we believe that black here only gets a few points, but white gets a very strong wall that is worth a lot more than these points in the corner. But computer doesn't seem to agree with that. First of all, after this variation, black still has Sente, so it can't be too bad, right? And second, AI offered some improvements that we can do to this. Now, this exchange is not really the best, it seems, because right after this, white becomes too strong. So computers think that at this point, black shouldn't play here, but instead maybe push here one more time. And if white responds, now Tanuki and take Sente, and consider this wall not too strong yet. Black can still hope to attack this in the future. And another improvement, which is probably even more important, is that this move is not the best. We thought that it's inevitable, but computers think that at this point, white really has two options. The first one is playing here, which leads to an enormous amount of complicated variations. So we're not going to deal with that right now. But you can look into this if you're curious. But if you want to keep things simple, white can always simply extend. And this move lets you avoid all of the complications. Because right now, if black doesn't respond, white can enclose the corner, and now black has difficulty living here. So black has to add another move, for example, like this. Black gets the corner, but now white gets Sente and not black. So now white gets a chance to enclose this corner, or invade this corner, or play anything he wants. And that's very important. Oh, and surely 4-4 is not the only move that's available to us at the start of the game. We can still play something else, computers say. We can play 3-4, for example. So if we play like this, then the value of corners is still incredibly big. And right after this, we should consider enclosing one of the corners. Before, we used to do it like this, or like this, even like this. But AI's favorite move is this one, which is less safe than the other enclosures, but it offers a lot more flexibility for future play. But does it really mean that this is the only possible corner enclosure and everything else is inferior? Well, no. And if you like to play other corner enclosures, by all means, you can continue doing so. There's really nothing wrong with playing this, that, or this. By the way, you can also watch these lessons on our platform, gomagic.org. Except there, you'll watch them with interactive quizzes right within the lessons and practical exercises right after them. And if you enjoy watching these Go videos and you don't want to miss others like this one, go smash that like button, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and this is Go Magic.